Hello, hope you're doing great. This is Marie Panni Rajan, your friendly software developer. And in this video, we're going to talk about loops. Machines are very good at doing the same thing over and over again. Even the machines that we use on an everyday basis, like a ceiling fan, once you switch it on, the fan just keeps rotating again and again and again. It just keeps on going in the same loop. Right? So any machine for that matter is, you know, like really good at doing the same thing again and again and again. Things that we as humans would get bored of, right? Like rotating the ceiling fan again and again, you know, to do that physically, to do that manually, it would be like one of the most boring jobs ever. But machines, you know, do that for us. That's the main advantage of, you know, like having machines do the boring and repetitive tasks, basically. And to enable us to do these repetitive tasks using the software programs that we write, we have these looping statements. And in this video, we're going to talk about two of the most commonly used looping statements that is available in Python, which is for loops and the while loop. All right, so let's take a problem statement and let's try to solve that problem using our loops, right? So the problem that we are going to solve in this video is to help, you know, mobile users send forward messages to selected friends. Now, this is something that we do on a regular basis, right? Like, you know, using an app like WhatsApp, you know, like if you see a worthwhile message and you want to share it to, you know, a couple of your friends, we can just touch that respective message and, you know, you get the option to share it. And then you can even choose, you know, the list of friends to whom you want to send that message to as a forward. Now just think about what is going on there. You know, like how is WhatsApp able to send that particular message, the same message, you know, that you selected to a list of your friends, right? Now there are these two components, right? One is the message, the same message, and then the second component is the list of your friends that you have selected. So the same message now needs to be sent to, you know, like the first friend, and then to the second friend, and then to the third friend, and so on, right? So if you had selected, like, let's say 10 friends, you know, it's just the same message that needs to be repetitively sent to each of these individual persons. Now, you know, as we know, to send these messages one by one to, let's say, 100 of our friends, you know, it's a very time consuming manual and repetitive process, right? So, you know, instead of doing that by means of just, you know, selecting all the list of friends whom you want to send it to and let WhatsApp, you know, just loop through each of these friends and send them the same message again and again and again, you know, that saves a lot of time, you know, and that's really powerful because, you know, instantaneously you get to send the same message to, you know, the list of 100 people that you had selected. So this is a perfect example where loops are being used. Now let's deconstruct it. All right. So, you know, like we said that in Python, we have these two different types of looping statements that are available, the for loop and the while loop. Now let's see the for loop. Now let's just try to understand how, you know, like we would be able to send a forward message to a bunch of selected friends using the for loop. Now, as a first step, we would definitely need the list of friends to whom we want to send this forward message to, right? So, you know, like we need a list. Let's say, for example, you know, as you select, you know, each of your friends in your phone, the names of each of those respective, you know, friends gets populated in this list. And let's say we want to send this forward message to Jack, Smita, and Alex, all right, for these three people. So in a high level view, the for loop looks like this. So yes, so it starts with the for keyword and then we have a variable. Here we have used the word friend, but it could be like X, Y, Dost or anything. All right. So this variable is where, you know, like each of the values that are present in the list are going to be, you know, stored per each loop. And then, you know, we say use the in keyword. All right. So for is a keyword and in is a keyword. And then, you know, we give an iterable data structure. Now list is a commonly used iterable data structure that is used along with for, you know, so that's what we are using here. So friends to share, you know, like the list that we declared here, right? So we're just making use of that here. And then, you know, we go inside the block of code. Based on the number of values that are present in this data structure, in this list, you know, like in our case, we have Jack, Smita, and Alex, right? So three times the for loop is going to go inside this block of code. So whatever, you know, block, whatever lines of code you write inside this block is going to get executed three times. And each time the value of friend would be different, all right? So the first time it will be the first index, Jack, all right? And the second time when it comes inside the loop, it would be the value Smita. And this third time it would be Alex, all right? So that's the basic premise of how, you know, a for loop is set up. Now let's see it in action in code, all right? So this is how we implement, you know, like this particular logic inside of Python. So in the first line, we are creating the list, you know, we're calling it friends to share message. And in that we have Jack, Smita, and, you know, Alex. And then, you know, we have the actual for loop statement. So, you know, as we discussed earlier, for is the keyword. And then we have the variable, which we are calling friend. And then in is another keyword. You can even see that the keywords are shown in a different color in our VS Code. And then, you know, the iterable data structure, which in our case is a list, right? So this particular indented block of code that we have, you know, is going to get executed three times because, you know, we have three values in this list. So let's just check this out. So, you know, I am just going to run this code, and you can see, you know, sharing forward to Jack got printed the first time, and the second time sharing forward to Smita, and the third time sharing forward to Alex got printed, you know, because sharing forward to is a string, and then we are just, you know, concatenating it with the variable friend, which is, you know, like the variable that we're using to, you know, iterate through each of the values that are present inside the list. So next we're going to talk about the while statement. The while statement is another commonly used, you know, looping statement. Now the main difference between the for loop and the while loop is, in the while loop, you get to customize the condition even further. So this will make more sense by actually doing it. So, you know, like for the same example of, you know, sending forward messages to a selected bunch of friends, let's do this using the while loop now. So this is the high level view of how a while loop is set up. So we have the keyword while, and then we define the condition. While this condition is true, keep executing the statements that are indented under the while block. So it's simple as that. And, you know, now let's just see this in action inside our VS Code editor. So here as well, you know, we got the list, Jack, Smita, and Alex. We're first getting the number of friends. You know, we get that by means of using this len helper function. And we know that the length is 3. So we have number of friends is equal to 3. And then we just initialize the variable index to 0. Here we can see the syntax. While is the keyword, and then we have the condition. So basically, while this condition is true, keep executing the lines that are below it. So the first time we come inside the loop, the value of index would be 0. And since it's 0, you know, like the value that will be fetched here is Jack, and that's getting assigned to friend. And we just concatenating it with the sharing forward to message. And then, you know, we keep incrementing the value of index. Index is equal to index plus 1. We just keep incrementing the value of index. And because of that, we get to iterate through each of the values that are present inside the list. Now, in a while statement, we are very explicitly responsible for, you know, making sure that this condition, you know, becomes false at some point. Because if this condition doesn't become false at some point, this loop is just going to be running forever and ever and ever. For fun, you know, let's just create an infinite loop now, all right? So if we just remove this particular line of code, that is, if we don't increase the value of index, let me just comment this out. So if we don't increase the value of index is going to stay 0. So every time it checks for the condition, it is always going to be true, because 0 is always going to be less than, you know, number of friends, which is 3, right? So it's just going to keep, you know, printing the same message again and again and again. So let's even run this and see. You know, we can see now that, you know, the statement sharing forward to Jack is just, it just keeps running again and again and again. Why? Because this condition is never going to become false, because, you know, index is never incremented. So this is something that we need to be careful about, you know, to not create unintended, you know, infinite loops. So yes, loops are very powerful, and especially, you know, like to take care of repetitive tasks, loops are your friends. I hope this video was useful, and I'll see you in the next video. Cheers.